Rivers State Governor Yesomezo Wike has stated that Nigerian workers will be better off when states are allowed to fix their separate minimum wages in line with their financial capacity to pay. Speaking during a public hearing on the new national minimum wage for Nigerian workers for the South-South Two Political Zones in Port Harcourt on Friday, Governor Wike said that states vary in financial capacity, making a uniform minimum wage unrealistic.
And for all, therefore, the single national minimum wage system is yet another lie that betrays the distortions in our federation and the structural dislocation of the states in the power equation between the federal government and the federating states. Therefore, it's our view that the country and its workers will be better off if the states are allowed to fix and pay their own minimum wages index to the prevailing cost of living and ability to pay. When this happens, it is possible that some states may go beyond the minimum threshold to pay a living wage, which is what our workers truly need.
Governor Wike said that previous review exercise failed to give maximum weight to the existing disparity in economic potential and capabilities among the 36 states of the Federation, adding that it has been difficult for most of the states to implement the existing 18,000 minimum wage.
The previous review exercise failed to give maximum weight to the existing disparity in economic potential and capabilities among the 36 states of the Federation. And we all know how difficult it was and has been for most of the states to implement the existing 18,000 minimum wage.
He noted that majority of the states are within the fringes of financial viability and cannot meet their salary obligations to civil servants without bailout funds from the federal government.
Even now, majority of the states within the fringes of financial viability are finding it extremely difficult to meet their salary obligation to civil servants without bailout from the federal government.
He said that enhanced wages can only be possible when the federal government improves the economy of the federation.
Here in Rivers State, we value our workers, we invest in their welfare in different ways, and we want them to earn living wages that can keep them and their families as comfortable as possible. The Rivers State government, therefore, supports the ongoing consultations by the Tripartite Committee on National Minimum Wage for arriving at a new minimum wage floor for the country.
In his opening remarks, Minister of Labour and Productivity, Dr. Chris Ingie, said the exercise has been held across the six geopolitical zones to ascertain the needs of Nigerian workers and employers to reach an acceptable and implementable wage.
It is therefore hoped that at the end of this exercise, we will be able to have women and men who will be engaged in productive work in equitable conditions of freedom to associate and bargain collectively with equality and human dignity.
Ingige, who is also the chairman of Tripartite Committee on National Minimum Wage, said the aim is to ensure that the nation adopts a national minimum wage that will assure the attainment of social protection floor for Nigerian citizens.
We aim as a government to ensure that we adopt a national minimum wage that can assure the attainment of a social protection floor for Nigerian citizens.
Presenting the position of Nigerian Labour Congress in the South-South, Comrade Beatrice Otupu called for a living wage for workers.
That the new national minimum wage should be 66,500 naira. That the said minimum wage should be paid by all employers of labor.
Also speaking, representative of Trade Union Congress in the South-South, Comrade Austin Jonathan, pleaded that pensioners should be considered in the new wage regime.
So they should also look at the pensioners and increase their money as we are talking about this new minimum wage.
The public hearing attracted representatives of the governors of Bayelsa, Cross River, Akwa Ibom, Edo and Delta states. Also present at the meeting were labor leaders from the six states of the geopolitical zone.